Hello, and welcome to our Introduction to Guide video. The purpose of this video is to serve as a starting point for people looking to learn to program in the PLUS+1 Guide environment. We'll try to keep the content in this video to a minimum, but point you to other videos in our channel in the correct order to get you familiar with the PLUS+1 system. This will also allow you to watch the videos in smaller chunks, so you can start and stop your training as time allows. Let's get started. Begin with the question, what is PLUS+1? Many people respond to this question with the response, guide. For those of you who don't know, guide is the programming environment for PLUS+1 within which you can develop new applications. But PLUS+1 is more than guide. PLUS+1 is a total ecosystem for electrohydraulic control systems. It comprises guide to build the application and the PLUS+1 service tool to download the application and for further interactions with the application, such as setting parameters. But it also includes pre-written higher-level functions that you can integrate into your program so you don't have to reinvent the wheel and can get your machine out the door faster. And of course, it includes hardware, both hydraulic hardware like pumps, motors, and valves, but also electronic equipment like controllers, display sticks, joysticks, and sensors that have all been designed and tested to work smoothly in the PLUS+1 environment. But the heart of PLUS+1, where we give our machines customization, control, and intelligence, is the PLUS+1 Guide programming environment. So that's where we'll begin. The first thing you'll need to do is to get PLUS+1 Guide installed and licensed on your PC. For that, please watch the video entitled Intro to PLUS+1 Software and Installation and Guide. You can either search in our YouTube channel or look for the link for this and subsequent videos in the comments below. Also note that development of the videos in this series is an ongoing process and that new versions of Guide are coming out regularly, so the version presented in the video may not always be the most recent, but the general content should still be valid, perhaps with some minor changes. Return here when you've finished with that video. Your PLUS+1 Guide license permits you to install and run Guide on two PCs concurrently. Once you've got the software licensed on the first PC, licensing on the second and subsequent PCs in the case of a lost PC, personnel change, etc., is done through a process called rehosting. If you're ready to install on a second PC immediately, you can watch the following video, Rehosting PLUS+1 Guide License, for instructions. Otherwise, you can skip to the next video. Once you've got the PLUS+1 Guide software installed, the next step is to get familiar with its interface, how to navigate in the software, and how to customize the environment to your liking. For help on this, take a minute to watch the video, Overview of Guide, Menus, Landing Page, and Settings. You're almost at the point of setting up your first project in Guide. For each project, though, you'll need to tell Guide which device the application is intended for and what its attributes are. This information is contained in a hardware or HWD file. You can get these files, as well as the other files necessary or useful for Guide, as well as updates for the Guide itself on our website. A far easier way, however, is to use our PLUS+1 Update Center, which will automatically alert you to available updates, fetch them from our server, and install them on your computer. This is an extremely useful and time-saving feature, and we'd strongly encourage you to use it. Learn more about the Update Center by watching the video, Update Center. Once you're familiar with the general setup of Guide and its menus, icons, and navigation panes, the next step is to set up a project within which you'll build your first application. For that, watch the video Setting Up a New Project in Guide to see how this is done. once you've got a project set up, you're ready to begin coding your application. Since Guide is a visual programming language, instead of typing out the programming instructions, you mostly draw the data flows in your program. In order to do that, you first got to learn the drawing commands in Guide, which will allow you to build your application. Watch the video entitled Drawing Commands for an introduction to this. We said that Guide applications are primarily drawn instead of typed, as they would be in a text-based programming language. Another difference is how the program is broken up into more easily understandable chunks. In text-based languages, this is typically accomplished in procedures and functions. In Guide, code is organized into pages. To understand Guide code and to create more complex and sophisticated programs, you'll have to understand how to create and modify pages and page interfaces. Watch the video Page Interfaces in Guide to get started on this. You're now ready to build your first application. There's a good chance that you've already done some programming in a text-based language like Java or Python or C. If so, or even if you haven't, you're probably familiar with the first application that everyone writes in a new setup, Hello World. This is a program that's not very interesting from a logic point of view, but allows you to verify that all the environment settings are correctly configured and that you can successfully create and compile a program in the development environment. We have our own version of a Hello World program, but one more relevant to the electrohydraulic control environment for which Guide is designed. This is our pressure alarm program. Watch the video Building Your First Application to get started on this first simple application. That was a very simple first application, but you'll find that your programs will get progressively more complex and sophisticated. One thing that can be enormously useful in speeding up your program development are function blocks and compliance blocks. Say you're trying to implement a PID control on a signal. This could be a very complex function, and you could write your own using the basic components in Guide. But wouldn't it be nice if Danfoss engineers had already written and tested the code for you and made it available in the Guide environment? Well, it turns out that they have for a number of frequently used functions, which are organized into function block libraries, along with compliance block libraries, which act as drivers for a variety of Danfoss hardware. Learn about both of these code blocks, as well as other information about the Danfoss software hierarchy in the video Function and Compliance Blocks and the Danfoss Software Hierarchy. Once you've got your application written and compiled in Guide, now you want to download it to your device, be it a controller or a display or something else, like a programmable joystick. For this, you'll use the other primary tool in the PLUS+1 environment, which is the service tool. You develop your application in Guide, and then you use the service tool to download it to your device. Once it's on the device, you also use the service tool to monitor what's going on in the application and to adjust parameters. To get familiar with the PLUS+1 service tool, watch the video Basic Use of the Service Tool. Some people are developing applications for a single controller that will be doing its task in isolation and will not be communicating with any other devices on the machine. This is unusual, however. Typically, they will be exchanging information with other devices, and in Guide, that normally means communications over the CAN bus. To understand how CAN communications are handled in Guide programs, watch the video CAN Communications in PLUS+1 Guide. One of the strengths of Guide is that it is largely standard across platforms. The Guide programs that you develop for the MC50112 controller, for example, will be mostly the same as those that you develop for the SC24110 or for the JS1H joystick, Within the existing hardware constraints on memory, input and output capabilities, etc. Not surprisingly, display programming, however, is slightly different. The pure guide part of the program and the logic reflected there remain the same. Creating a project, drawing code, organizing into pages, all that is the same in a controller or a display program. A display program has some additions, however, as it has to be able to create and display static and dynamic screen content. If you'll be developing applications for Danfoss displays, you will want to learn about display programming, and that you can start with by watching Getting Started on the VBSE, which stands for the Vector-Based Screen Editor. The previous video should get you started for developing a simple display application. On the other hand, if you're going to be developing a more sophisticated display with many different screens, it might not be immediately obvious how to organize and transition between them. We recommend a state machine approach to this, and the video State Machine for Display Applications gives you one possibility for how this can be accomplished in Guide. With that, we come to the end of our string of videos to introduce you to the basics of PLUS+1. We hope that this is enough to get you started using Guide and the Service tool, but there are many more videos available to give you more specifics about certain functionalities. We will be continually adding videos to the channel, so subscribe to get alerts when new content is added. Thanks for your attention and happy programming. Remember that PLUS+1 community help is available on the PLUS+1 user forum at plus1forum.danfoss.com or contact the PLUS+1 help desk at plus1helpdesk@danfoss.com. PLUS, the plus sign.